you.
Hey, welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. Kim, I've got good news and I've got bad news.
Oh, I want, just give it all to me, Lee.
The bad news is this will not work on the iPhone.
Oh, okay.
That's a real bummer there, too, because this is really cool. This is a website called JotYou, JotYou.com. Really interesting concept. What it lets you do is to set up a message. You can put it on your phone. You send it out to your friends, but they only get it within a certain time block and within a certain geographical area.
Huh. So in practical terms, you would use this to...
Well, let's say, you know, you invited a bunch of friends down to a city place in West Palm Beach.
Okay.
But they're from all over the county. They're coming here from after work.
Right.
When they get close, you have a message ready for them, and it hits their phone saying where you're meeting them.
Oh, tell me, meet me at Panera Bread. I'm in front of Panera Bread right now.
And let's say somebody's running late, and you're going to be moving after that.
Right.
Or you give an expiration time to your message so that, let's say, after 7 o'clock, that message disappears.
Okay. Hmm. All right. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
Is it hard or what? Is it what?
Hard?
No, it's easy to do.
Is it expensive?
It's free.
Oh, I didn't think there would be anything else, but it was talking about you.
But, you know, logging in here, it's real easy. You do have to set an email up and everything to log into your account.
Okay.
But once you're in here, you install the software on your mobile phone.
And that's
where you get into the trouble part because it doesn't work on the iPhone.
But you BlackBerry, Android,
I don't know about Android,
all those kind of phones.
A lot of them out there.
Okay.
You can also track the motion of your group so you can see on the map where everybody is.
Wow.
So it's got some really neat things. Give you a quick rundown of the phones. The Nokia smartphones it works on. Windows Mobile 5 and 6 and
BlackBerry. A lot of people have those, yeah.
So a lot of great things there.
So you want to do a flash mob, right?
Yeah.
You know, where people come together or just kind of like through text messaging, they all kind of join together. You could use a service like this to do that.
Okay.
I'll have to put that on my list of things to do now.
Well, you can't do it. You've got an iPhone.
Oh, okay.
Jamey's going to talk to us about books.
Yes, we love books. We love books. But the thing about this set of books is that you don't have to read these books. You know, popular things that have come up lately have been audiobooks, but sometimes audiobooks can be twice the cost of regular books. Well, this website, PodioBooks.com, PodioBooks.com, allows you to be able to download all sorts of audiobooks down to your iTunes account, and then you can put it on your iPod, and you can listen to these audiobooks for free.
Nice.
It's very, very cool. So I want to go to the FAQ, and then I want to go, how do I subscribe to a book? There's a couple of ways that you can do this. You can click listen when you find a book that you want to listen to, and then it will. You can register for an account here if you want to, and then it can download it to a podcatcher. So if you're subscribed to an RSS feed, it will not automatically upload that to you to your particular RSS feed.
Nice.
Or you can go straight to iTunes, and you can just put it in your iTunes library, just as easy as a click, and then you can download it onto your computer. A lot of people copy it on a CD, or they'll put it on their iPod or whatever MP3 player they have.
Neat.
Very cool, very easy to do, and it's very easy to search. So, for example, if I wanted to look for a fantasy book, I would just go up here, click on fantasy, press go, and then it's going to list all of the fantasy books, and you can look, they have the covers there for you, and it's very easy. You just look through the fantasy books. It has descriptions of the book. There is even a community here that rates the books, so you can look and see which ones are more popular, and then you can just pick that book. So it really allows you to be able to get involved with literature. You know, you can listen all the time, so you're educating yourself, and there are just hundreds and hundreds of books there. So Patio Books is the way to go for audio books for free, baby.
It's free.
I heard you rebuke me before about, you know, $5, 5 cents, you know, so we're going to get this one free for you.
Do they have good books, current books? I mean,
yes, they're all current, and the reason that they're doing this is because of the fact that some of the authors want to just get exposure, so they get it for free, hopefully you'll be able, you know, you'll maybe buy the hardcover, or maybe you buy the next book that comes out. So the authors are doing this, and then we just get the benefits of it.
So when you write your book, Life and Times on Palm Breeze Cafe,
Life and Times on Palm Breeze Cafe, check it out on Patio Books, baby. Mm-hmm.
All right.
Kim, you're back to the tech.
I know. I'm geeking it up.
You're really geeking it up.
This is my favorite website to find breaking news.
Okay.
And again, I like to keep up with the trends and see what's happening out there in the tech world. Part of my job is to keep track of these things, and it's called TechMeme.com.
I thought it was Mimi.
No, TechMeme. a meme is a set of ideas, like a gene, but it's something that you follow. And what this site does is it pulls in information from all over the web, from blogs, from Twitter, from news feeds, and it rates them basically behind the scenes and pops the most popular one at the top. So you always have the most popular techie news article right at the top of the list. And so for today, the most popular news article is a new service from Google that lets you go in and find out what Google knows about you. This could be something that you have to have, if you have a Google account and you're using it with like iGoogle or something like that, everything you do is being tracked by Google. And now they're opening up, they're becoming more transparent, and they've got that kind of news article. Also big in the news today, Steve Jobs was named the CEO of the decade from Fortune magazine. And you can just scroll on down the list and maintain, if you're you're a serious geek, you can keep up your geek creds by staying right on top of the latest news. You can also look at news by categories and so forth. You can set up personal things like that. But lots of really interesting news here. And you know, when geeks like to get together, they want to one-up each other. Hey, man, I'm always on top of things because I just visit
the TechMeme. You're right at the top of the
list. It only takes a little while to scan down, find the news that matters to me.
Okay.
So, and speaking of people that matter to me, Lee Kolbert over there.
Pizap. I don't know, but this is a great site. It's so much fun. I've been having a ball with this. This is a site where you can just edit some photos and really make them fun. You can put some speech bubbles. You can create a greeting card. You can create maybe a poster for your classroom. Maybe put some storybook characters and have them say something that's characteristic of their character. But let me show you, because I know we're short on time today. Pizap. Click on start. And what I'm gonna, and you really don't even have to create an account. So that's really nice, kind of disposable technology. You can create your picture from a webcam, just kind of on the fly, or you can upload an image. That's what I'm gonna do right now. I have a picture here of me and Jamey.
Like that picture, Lee. Like it.
And I can just throw in a speech bubble here.
Uh-oh.
And I can resize it, and I can just drag it
around. What's up, girlfriend?
And I can type in whatever I want. I love you, Lee.
I do, girl.
And when I like it, there it is. I can just, and then of course I can move it around and edit it, and I can change all kinds of things around it. But what's also fun about this is there's plenty of stickers, and I can also, create kind of a cartoon effect by using their fonts with nice colors around it. There's some fun stickers. I can put a little sparkle on Jamey's teeth. Yeah, if I don't like it, I'm just going to go ahead and recycle. Jamey didn't know I was going to play with her like this, right? Hearts and flowers. How about some bling? Jamey, I think you need some bling. I'm going to
go ahead
and give her a little necklace here.
Oh, and I see.
Nice.
Yeah.
And, of course, I need a tiara.
I see a spot for you to have a goblet in your hand, too. Perfect.
And let's see. We've got some emoticons. We've got different pictures here. We've got... phrases even. I mean, look how fun this is. We've got here, I can put princess, and I've got here Jamey saying, whatever. So this is great fun, and you can share it, you can put it public, you can download it, and if you're not busy enough, you will. Look at it, it's going to be fun. Never stand.